Hi, Jonathan here, and welcome to this week edition of the Market Update. Today is 10th of May 2020, and the time right now is 8:50 p.m. A lot of you are like, what's going on with the market? So let's check. But before that, do remember to, if you're watching this from YouTube, do remember to join the gathering of traders. Do also remember to go to your Telegram and search for this group, Gathering of Traders, so that you're able to get the real-time trade alert inside here and whatever trade signals that are available, and also market updates. And do remember to join my YouTube channel. Do remember to click like on this video. Do remember to subscribe, and do remember to share this YouTube and this group with all your trading friends. I really appreciate it very much. Okay, so let's talk about the market. Now, if you take a look at the market, you will notice that Nasdaq, everyone is talking about Nasdaq right now because Nasdaq is way above January 1st, whereas Dow and S&P are still below. So some of you are wondering why. But before that, let's take a look at what's going on this week. This week, do remember, is the third week of the month, which means it is an option expiration week. That means for those of you trading options, it is a week that you have to pay attention to your position. But as a trader, what do we do? It is a week where there's a lot of whipsawing. So generally, if the stock that you're looking at has been going higher, there is a possibility that during option acceleration week, it will come down, or vice versa, if the price has been come down, it may go higher. So let's watch, okay? So you notice that last Friday, we have the non-farm payroll. It was a very bad non-farm payroll, but yet market goes higher. Why? Let's take a look in a short while. So numbers of data expected to be bad, okay? As normal, we have the Uncle DJT. Right now, in order to let people be bonded as one, everyone needs to have a common enemy. Well, we cannot have a common enemy, which is the flu, because it's invisible. So let's have a common enemy, which is the trade versus China. Okay. And also, of course, the UK. Basically, let's just put this a fact. Every economic numbers are bad and expected to be bad. But what boggles the mind is, why is US market continue to go higher? And Bitcoin, you remember, third halving is coming, okay, on Tuesday. So we'll take a look at gold, oil, and Bitcoin in a short while, okay? But if you notice, whatever you say, there's nothing that can be said about this flu. This flu caused economic havoc, caused lifestyle havoc, caused manufacturing, everything. But yet, if you take a look at the S&P, which is similar to Dow Jones, look at that. Okay, but the biggest difference that right now people find it boggles the mind is, if this is S&P, let's take a look at Nasdaq. It's practically no flu. This is the start where the market start to fall. That was on the February 20th. And right now, we are practically nearby there. No flu. Nasdaq is like no flu. So a lot of new traders were like, couldn't get it. So let me ask you a very simple question. What is inside Nasdaq? Okay. A lot of you will know this, as most of the tech company are in Nasdaq. Okay. So let me ask you, what type of tech company? You will notice that a lot of all these tech companies are like Amazon, like Apple, like Spotify, like Netflix, like what else? PayPal, okay? And basically all those are online. Didn't you notice that with all these lockdowns, everyone is depending on technology? So which is why technology has no flu. There is no flu in technology, because everyone now, if you notice that your parents, our parents, who are not IT savvy, are forced to learn how to use a mobile phone. even if they are not very fluent with mobile phone, I bet they are extremely fluent with playing mobile games. Am I right? So which is why Nasdaq has been going up a lot faster. You want to buy something? You want to pay something? PayPal. So do you notice that recently with the earnings in PayPal, Netflix, everything, it's all because of this flu. But if you notice, the regional market indices like STI, KLCI, Jakarta Composite, all are also going higher. Okay, but mainly, why are they going higher is mainly following the US market. So why is US market going higher? For one main reason, Federal Reserve. If you notice that the Federal Reserve have been pumping money into the economy, whatever ways, Jerome Powell say they will do whatever it takes. Remember that statement used to be stated by Mario Draghi? So basically right now, Federal Reserve are also guaranteeing bonds. So what it means is, you notice a few weeks ago, go Google, Boeing no longer asks federal government to save them. They don't need. They just come up with their bonds. And then it was taken up. And whatever bonds that was not taken up, the Federal Reserve will set up a LLC company to take up the bonds. So in fact, the recent latest news is Federal Reserve will also participate into junk bonds. That means the low credibility company rating, they are also guaranteeing it. So in other words, there is absolutely hard for a company in the United States to fall. Even if the company is bad, rotten or whatever, they just come out with the bonds, someone will take up. So in other words, it's hard for a company to collapse moving forward. How long will it take till Federal Reserve guarantee it? Well, who knows? But basically for now, it is hard for a company to collapse in the United States and easy for them to come up with bonds and people subscribe to those bonds. So moving forward, will there be, freehand? No, it's not. It's going to be a managed economy for now. So it is actually good to set up a company. Doesn't matter whether what company it is and come up with bonds, and that's how you can make money from, not from the business itself, but from free money. Okay, what's the worst case? Company declare bankrupt there, but the money's gone. Oh well, that's the new economy moving forward. So let's analyze the S&P at this moment. Okay, you will notice that last week I was talking about all that beautiful shooting star that was showing up. And Nasdaq.
Here's what I found on the web.
Oops. Basically, Nasdaq. This is Nasdaq. As expected, killed that shooting star. Whew, powerful. So perhaps at this very moment, there is a possibility that we may hit this 200 simple moving average, which is right here. And it won't be a surprise if we go a little bit higher, which is a classical resistance, which is right here. I'm surprised the market is that strong. I am actually very surprised. Oh well, overall, we are still having a higher high, higher low for now. So the thing is, Nasdaq broke higher. There is a gap resistance right about here. So we may go up to touch this, which is actually very, very close. Which is very, very close. So watching that out very closely. So the market has reached checkpoint Charlie. Alpha, Beta, Charlie. But the thing is, will it be overstretched? There is a risk. The risk is getting higher the longer we go in. Okay? So if you take a look, not only in the US market, but if we take a look at the London, the big news is Brexit is still back in the news. It is not as bullish as US. Okay, look at it. Why? Mainly for one main reason. Remember just now I talked to you about Federal Reserve coming into the market. Federal Reserve will do whatever it takes to make sure the bonds are subscribed so that the company will not collapse. That is in US. The same thing is not in other countries. That means like Malaysia, like Singapore, like Thailand, like Indonesia. Most of the countries around the world, I wouldn't say all, but most of the countries around the world, they are encouraging, they are subsidizing the company, but they are not guaranteeing the company per se. So which is why the US market is the strongest among the rest of the world. And the rest of the world trying to follow the United States. But do remember, they do not have that mountain behind them. That means they have no backup. Company may still collapse. So if you are investing in stocks, please do your own due diligence. Remember, whatever I shared is my personal opinion. If you like to trade, please do your own due diligence. Take a look at London. The biggest news, I was watching the Chinese News Asia just now, is Brexit. So Brexit news is back again in London. So take note of that. And because of this, they are not negotiating. So there could be a hard Brexit. So take note. Okay. And this means you have to watch the Germany DAX. So Germany DAX, for now, I'll be watching this 200. If S&P continue to go up, may pull the Europe continue to go up. So I'll be watching this 200 as a possible resistance. And nearby here, which is the 61. So you notice this whole range here are a very strong resistance for Germany DAX. So watching that level very, very closely. Okay, so I will also be watching, and I'm also vested in gold. Okay. Basically, we are trading in a range. This is gold weekly candle. We are trading within the range of here and here. And this is the third week after that shooting star. If we cannot go down, then this will be a consolidation. And in the chart pattern, we call this a bullish pennant. See here? There's a triangle right there. So if we cannot, basically, it will be a bullish pennant. So do you notice that there's the range of movement last week is smaller than the previous week, is smaller than the previous week. Look at the range. So this week, gold either should break lower or break higher. I'm watching these two levels extremely closely. Okay, so on a daily candle, we have a sort of a bearish candle on Friday, okay? And if you remember on Thursday, it was extremely bullish. Why? Because it's a flower full moon. Flower full moon. The last super moon of this year, I think. Yeah, there was someone mentioning last super moon of this year. So that's why gold went up. Oh well, one of those predictions, okay? So you notice that see here? This is daily candle. Notice the Bollinger Band are being squeezed. It also tells us that volatile movement should be coming soon, either going higher or going lower. I'll be watching it. Vested, I am currently in a short position and losing money at this moment. And if it does go higher, I will just cut loss. If it goes lower, I'll add on to my short position in gold, and if it does go lower, I'll be watching this 200. So that's my position in gold. Okay, now everyone is talking about oil, and a lot of brokers are allowing the oil trade to, allowing people to open back their oil position. That is the oil futures contract. So right now, I have no signal. Basically, I am not looking at oil for this moment, but because there is absolutely no signal at this moment. This is the oil futures contract. Where's my, oh well, show all. Where's my oil cash contract? That is oil cash contract. Notice the chart is extremely, extremely different. Yeah. Oh well, depending on what you want to trade, but currently I am not looking into the oil positions. Okay. The next one everyone is talking about is Bitcoin. Because of the halving. Look at that. Look at that. We are very close to the February high. Okay, very close. On a hindsight, there was a beautiful candle right here. Okay, that's on hindsight. And you notice the market trend. Crypto trainers that were quiet suddenly now are back again. So that's the market trend. Oh, which reminds me, gold. Look at that. If I change this to a weekly candle, no, not weekly candle, monthly candle. I don't have the history, but basically, not in this chart, okay? But basically, gold right now is at the very near to the all-time historical high. The previous time that gold was at this range, the hottest news in the market was Geneva gold. We are right at that point of time where is Geneva gold. But why Geneva gold was very hot at that point of time is because gold price at that time was one straight line up. So the gold scheme are all, investment scheme are all in, because gold is like one straight line up. Similarly, previously when Bitcoin was like one straight line up right here, that's why we have Bitcoin investment scheme. Now you notice the Bitcoin investment scheme is not as rampant. Similarly, also like gold, not as rampant, because this is like that. So it's hard to, it's like not a sure win thing. That means last time is one straight line, buy anytime, sure make money. Buy Bitcoin anytime, sure make money. But you notice, this is the Bitcoin movement. People don't dare to buy because can lose money. Last time is almost guaranteed right here. You can make money, guaranteed. Buy anytime, almost guaranteed make money. But not now. Okay, so you notice that right now Bitcoin is about 50% from the high. So what I'm trying to share is, because of the flood in money, because all the government are printing money around the world, moving forward there will be a lot of investment scheme coming up, and some of those investment scheme can be extremely creative. So please do your own due diligence if you want to participate in any of the investment scheme. Okay, so basically this week, if you notice the last week, I haven't been doing much of a YouTube because I've been doing live trading with all the graduates. Do not ask me to how to join because it is currently not opened. We have been doing a lot of live trading and it's really tiring, and we'll be doing it this week again. But let me see, I'm backlogged in some YouTubes that I mentioned that I'll be doing. The moment I got an opportunity, I will do that YouTube. Okay, so do remember to please like this video. Do remember to subscribe to my YouTube channel. And do remember to share this YouTube with all your trading friends so they get to learn how to look at the market using charts. Be safe. Bye.